So I see our comptroller here. Can you all give our comptroller, Joan Pratt, a big round of applause? She wasn't on the ballot, but she's always a winner anyway. It just gives me great pleasure just to work with her. And we sit together every Wednesday morning. I'll wait for you all. Just only going to be a few minutes. Shh. Only a few minutes, you all. It gives me great joy every Wednesday. I sit with Joan, and we also sit on our finance board together, and we do a lot of good things. So, and I know I've got some department heads here. I saw the Office of Employment Development, Jason Perkins Cohens, who is responsible for making sure or helping people to work in Baltimore, including our youth. I see Reggie Moore. Reggie Moore is head of our Parks and Recreation Department. I saw Paul Taylor earlier. I'm going to stop because I can't call everybody's name. Just can't do it. But I'm excited. I hope that you all take time to really consume the work of, to me, one of the greatest artists that I've ever known, and I've known quite a few. And I've also championed the art of many. But I met Poncho Brown back in the, before he became famous, Paul Taylor, I met him as owner of African American News and World Report, a newspaper that I had started. And when I viewed his art, I was just spellbound. And I saw him back in February of this year, and I said, Poncho, I said to him, I really would love for you to display your art in City Hall. And what he said to me is that I would like to do it for Black Music Month, because I have a series of pieces that demonstrate music. And so you'll see, in honor of Black Music Month, many of his pieces here in City Hall represent musicians. But also, let me just point you to this piece here. We are having a silent auction, and you can bid on this particular piece. It's a signed piece by Poncho and framed. That's exciting. So let me also present to you Poncho Brown, one of my great artists, one of the artists that I adore. But also, can you give a round of applause to our musicians who are here? We have Dr. Fun and the Dunbar High School Jazz Band, who has been a part of the fabric of this city for quite some time. And we have Philip Ellington Dancer Connections Middle High School. You'll see some of their art. We also have Roderick Carlton Demings. I think you've heard him play. I saw a video of him playing one time, and I used to take piano lessons many moons ago, but I've never had that kind of talent. I see our councilman. How you doing, councilman? Did you get a chance to take a look at the art? Did you want to bid on this piece? I won't put you on the spot. Thank you. Thank you. Well, we can talk about that. In 2009, the commemoration was given. One of his current names is in reference to some of the pieces that he's done. President Barack Obama, and in his 2016 proclamation, Obama noted that African American music and musicians have helped this country. No dance to express our faith through song, to march against injustice, and to defend our country's enduring promise of freedom and opportunity for all. Art expresses so many different moods of our race and ethnicity, and also it is a way for us to express how we feel and think. I think that you'll find all of those expressions in the work of Poncho Brown. Poncho Brown, come forward. Joan and I want to present to you this citation. And Joan's going to share a few words, and then we're going to present you with another piece.
Okay.
Okay. In the middle?
In the middle.
Okay.
You want to
Good evening, everyone. First, I would like to thank Poncho, and I would like to thank Poncho for giving me the opportunity to work for him for a decade. You said the 80s, we go back from the very beginning, and Poncho, I'd just like to thank you for giving me that opportunity. And in celebration of the African American Appreciation Month, it is a great honor for us to have the opportunity to present this exhibition of artwork from the Soundscapes collection by Larry Poncho Brown. Let's give him another round of applause. And so, Poncho, is all of your work available for sale?
Everything is for sale.
So the creativity and the inspiration of his work here colorfully captures the essence of the history and culture of Black music. And I would like to thank Poncho for displaying his artwork here at City Hall. And I am so excited that all of you have come here to view this exquisite Soundscapes collection. And, you know, please take the opportunity to view his exhibition and please purchase his, as you heard him say, all of his artwork is for sale. Thank you.
Poncho, wait a minute for you. Joan, you can put. We also wanted to present you with the mayor's medallion.
Oh, wow. Wow. I'm so glad my head wasn't too big for that to fit over my neck. That would have been so embarrassing. I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. Music is one of those things that's universal. You know, I've been told as an artist that art is universal, but nothing is more universal than music is. But I want to go back to my roots. Baltimore is dear to me. I see as I look in the audience, family members, artists, friends, collectors. I don't take this journey very lightly. This is my 39th year as a professional artist. I was born and raised in Baltimore City. I went to Liberty Elementary. I went to Utah Elementary. You notice how many elementaries? I went to Garrison Middle School. I went to Carver Vocational Technical High School. And I went to the Maryland Institute College of Art. I purposely wanted to be educated in Baltimore. And for the longest time, I had some hang-ups about Baltimore. But the more I got involved in the arts, I realized Baltimore was prepping me for everything that I could do in my career. And I've traveled the world with my art. It's not very often that you find a city that rallies around its artists. And as one thing that's very, very important to me is to be an artist advocate. And so I want to first wave to all my artist friends, please raise your hands. Because I really spent a lot of time with nurturing artists, especially Baltimore artists. Art is a difficult business. It's a dog-eat-dog business. But it's also a business that racism shows up into. Because you can imagine if an African American like me submits to the average show with the work that you see on the walls, some of that work might not get admitted. It's been happening for 39 years. So when I see people that really appreciate the work, because this work is really designed with you in mind. It's not a slogan. It's designed to celebrate my people. I always want to do positive images of who we are. And the pieces that you see in this collection are just my musical pieces. I have literally thousands of works. I'm always working. Paul Taylor can attest to that. He was with me back in 1995 when I had my studio fire. And I want to say a special thank you to Paul because he was one of the people that stepped up to help me, and so was Joan Pratt. That was a devastating circumstance that I had to completely start over in 1995. And he was responsible for housing me in my first studio after the fire. So give him a round of applause, too. we often don't get a chance to say thank you to certain people. That's why I wanted to do that. Another thing, too, is that we have to learn how to rally the arts in Baltimore City. There are a lot of art initiatives happening in the city, but there are not enough art initiatives that affect people that look like me. And that's what I've devoted my life to, trying to create opportunities like that. Back in the early 90s and late 80s, I used to do what was known as the African American Art Youth Exhibition that was housed right here in this building, where I invited students all over the city to participate so that they can have an opportunity to participate in an exhibition that reflects their work. And so it's a labor of love. All art is for sale with that labor of love. that's just a joke. if we don't rally for the arts, we will. All art programs in the city and other cities are having problems. And I've watched, as I travel the country and speak across the country, many schools that are closing down art and music programs. Ask yourself, what happens to those students when that happens? And we're really literally experiencing the outcome of that now. When I started into this business 39 years ago, there was a fire for African American art. Everybody was hungry, they were looking for their culture. It was as big as what the Black Panther was when this thing came out in the early 80s. But now it's been 25 years, another whole generation has come behind that, and I'm beginning to see and witness what happens to people that don't have art engagement. And it's affecting our children and by leaps and bounds. And if I can see it in the generation behind that, imagine what it's going to be in every generation after that. And so we have to start more programs, get more involved. I always tell people, you know, well, what should I do with my child? He draws, but I don't know where to put him. I said, just buy him packs of paper. It's cheaper than everything else you could buy, your phones, the PlayStations and all that stuff. Paper is cheap. We have to change our attitude towards how we support our children. My son is an artist. I'm a second generation artist. My father, he also attended Carver Vocational Technical High School. He also taught in the Baltimore City school system for 33 years before he passed away in 2011. And so I want to give homage to my father because he's part of me today. I want to thank you all for coming out. I hope you will take the time to experience the work that's on the walls. We also are going to put this piece up for auction. I don't auction often. I give away a lot of art, but I don't do auctions often. And we're going to do a silent auction on this piece to benefit Youth Works. So penciling your bids. Bid start at $600. I'm not going to tell you what the piece is worth until the winner wins. But I hope you'll take time, enjoy yourselves, have some food, and thank you again for coming out.
I wanted to also take a moment to thank our staff, Tanya Miller, who's our public affairs director. Tanya Miller. And one of the things that Tanya likes to say is that we really want to make City Hall alive. This is your City Hall. So this is one invitation that some of you responded to. Others have responded to other invitations. We will continue to do this because we believe that this is your City Hall. And so you'll see exhibits and you'll get invited to exhibits from time to time. And we hope you'll come out and support. Thank you.
I want to say thank you to a couple of people. One, I want to say thank you to Tanya Miller for putting this together. I also want to thank two real silent people, and that was Jeffrey Kent, who curated the show. He hung it. He came and picked it up from my studio, and Cleo Rose, who also worked very, very hard for 2 months to organize this event. Thank you.
So we're going to have Philip Ellington. Philip Ellington is going to do a dance for us. Only thing I can say is wow. I saw Councilman Pinkett earlier, and I see our Vice President of City Council, Middleton. Thank you for being here as well. Don't forget, you all, there's much to see, plenty of food, and don't forget to bid. It is for Youth Works, so please. Thank you all.